Yeah, there's a song called Blood Sings, which is about looking at pictures of my uncle and looking at pictures of my family in general, because the family, you know, in a family where everybody travels and everybody plays instruments and goes on the road, it's not a very strong family life. So there's been a lot of problems and a lot of alcoholism, and my uncle had a very short life and a very sad life, and so that was one of the things I was writing about in the new album.
You seem to me like a man on the verge of running 99.9 Fahrenheit degrees.
I like places that are urban. I like places that are kind of dirty or ugly, what most people would think of as ugly. Liverpool or the Ironbound section of New Jersey. These are places that are very dirty and very industrial. And it's because the reason I write about these places is because it reminds me of where I grew up, which is here in New York. And I guess I feel that I like to find things that other people have left behind and to see that they're beautiful, you know, because I grew up in really bad neighborhoods, and it wasn't like we went on vacation, or the most nature that we would get was going to the park, you know, and we go to the park and you see the trees and you see the river, and that seemed very beautiful to me. But if you grow up in a city like this, you learn to find things that are beautiful that other people might not think is beautiful, you know. You see broken glass on the sidewalk, and that's beautiful. Or you find some little plant growing, and that seems beautiful. Or you see some dirty children playing in the street, you know, in the fire hydrant, and that's beautiful. And that's the world I grew up in. Folk music is very strange, because I first started liking folk music because it was different from what my friends were listening to. So in my mind, if you liked folk music, you were independent, you had an independent mind, you weren't only listening to what was trendy or what was popular at the time. But I think a lot of people who like folk music like it to be traditional, they like to hear the songs they've always heard, and they like to, so maybe you're right, I'm not sure. I'm not sure who my audience is yet. I think it's changing.
We probably don't.
Let's do Blood Makes Noise in 2 minutes.
Thank you.
Well, I started working with Mitchell Froom because I liked his production with Richard Thompson. And he's done, I guess, the last three Richard Thompson records. And Richard Thompson is mostly known for playing acoustic guitar, but I could tell when I listened to the last album, which is called Rumor and Sigh, that whoever produced that album had a lot of imagination and was not afraid to mix up electric instruments with an acoustic bass. Bass meaning with the acoustic sound that it's that's the basic sound. And once I heard that, I was very intrigued. And then after I heard his work with Elvis Costello and with the Pretenders, I decided that I thought he was someone that I would like to work with. And of all the other producers that I interviewed, he seemed to have the most imagination.
You want that? The only other thing is that we could make that part just a little bit louder. Just that thing.
Yeah.
But the problem is it's
Let's wait till we hear what it sounds like with the monitors.
Yeah, that's right. I mean, we're all going
to be able to tell.
Yeah. You know,
I'm
it's like
get stuff
I can,
back from the house.
Mitchell's, it's really easy for us to have our monitor guy just, if we're having trouble with a particular tune, just to goose it.
Yeah.
It's not like we don't, you know, we have to leave it.
That's as loud as it gets.
I can do it.
I stand in a white flat land, no shadow or shade of a doubt. With a megaphone man, like the girl with her hand that's covering most of her mouth. Fall in love with a bright idea and the way the world is revealed to you. Fat man and dancing girl and most of the show.
That's true. The first time I met her, it seemed to me that I knew her from someplace else. And we became really good friends.
And I said, hey, you've got a gap in your teeth.
That's right. We had the same gap in our teeth.
And so we figured we were in the same club.
So, it's supposed to be good luck. So since then she's had many parties.
Appeal. She's really good.
No, I think it's also the thing I like about it is that it's not... They're not feminine and not masculine, and they are not like children's clothing, but not like adult clothing either. It's like everything all together. And that's what I really liked about them, is that... It's not, they're kind of boyish but feminine and, you know, it's not one thing or the other. There's been a lot of peculiar things in my life. I mean, I think even from the very beginning, the way I was born 2 months early, and I was 2.5 pounds when I was born, and so I had to be in an incubator for 5 weeks when I was first born. And I think that everything after that has been strange in some way or another, you know. I was raised in a half Puerto Rican family here in New York City. My family religion is Buddhist. And it's very unusual. I can't think of another family that's like my family or another person's life that's like my life. So to hear that all of this, to hear that my grandmother had been a musician on the road, it was a surprise, but it was as surprising as the rest of my life has been. I never would have thought I would have had a top 10 hit with Luca, which is a song about child abuse. Hasn't been anything about my life that I could predict.
Girls go.